Hey guys, in this video I will show you how you can make a webhook in Bubble. And with that webhook, what we will do is we will call it from outside the Bubble, and we will send it a unique ID of a user, and based on that it will go into the database. Bubble will search in the database for that user who has this unique ID that we will send from outside the Bubble through Postman. And then based on that, it will send the email, send a test email to the user who contains that unique ID that we will send to Bubble. So we will do that now. Before that, if you can't see backend workflows here, you need to go into the settings and you need to go into the API tab and check this check mark. Now what will happen is, now you can see a backend workflow tab down here. Just click on it. And now what we have to do is, we have to make a new API workflow. We can call it anything like my workflow. And for safety reasons, you can make it unchecked or checked. I will just make all of these checked for now, because this is a testing environment. So now what we will do is, we will not create a new parameter, but we will detect request data. Now there are two parameter definitions. One can be, we either create a manual definition, like what data will we be sending to this API. The thing that we have done in Bubble currently is that it is a whole API that is currently created in the Bubble. So we can call it from anywhere in the world, no matter what, as long as this app is live. So we need to define some parameters, like what we will be sending to this API. It could be any data, it could be names, it could be text, it could be images or numbers or anything. But currently what our requirement is that we want a user's unique ID of which we want to send an email to. So for now I will go for detect request data, and then I will open my app, which is Postman. So you can use Postman either from your desktop app, from its desktop app, or Postman is also available on the web browser, so you can use that as well. So just let it load. So once the Postman is loaded, you can create a new tab here and just remove the previous tabs from here. And then because our trigger workflow is post, we will make it as post. And now what we need to do is, we need to detect data. So now this button will be doing is, when we click on this data, Bubble will give us a URL. So this is a URL by which we can actually access this API that we have just created in Bubble. So so now what we have to do is, we need to paste this URL here, and then we have to come into the body, select this form encoding, URL encoded, and make a new parameter, like it will be user ID, user unique ID. Let me define it a little bit more, the unique ID, and we will pass it a value. So now from where we will actually get the value, we will get it from data. If you go into the users, if you click on edit, as you can see that you can get a unique ID from here of every user. It is unique to every user. So we will just paste it here. And if you want to send any additional parameters like name, which is, you can send those as well. You can send age, maybe it's 23. So you can send these as well. So now what we will do is, before calling this API, we will come back to Bubble, we'll go to workflow and click on detect data. So now Bubble is listening to our requests. So we will call this API we will say send, and it says success, then pad my workflow was successfully initialized. So this response is from Bubble. Bubble is saying the endpoint workflow was successfully initialized. So now, as you can see, Bubble has detected the data that we just sent it. So it has detected exactly three parameters that we sent it. It is a user's unique ID, a name, and an age as well, which is 23. As you can also see our raw data here. We sent it this data. So you can select it as number. Just save this response, and now here's the main part that you need to do. Don't forget doing this. So once you have detected your data and you have set up your parameters, now every time that you now will call this API, you need to remove initialize from here. This is very important. Initialize is only used in Bubble for the first time. After the API is initialized, you need to remove it before calling it in a production environment. So please keep that in mind. So now what you will do is, now what our requirement was actually to send email to users of whom we will get the unique ID from this call. So we will send an email. Now we will say do a search for users, and we will make a constraint by which we want to make a constraint. We want to make it from unique ID, and we will say they get the request data that we send from this environment and get the unique ID from here. So and get search for users whose unique ID is this unique ID that we just sent it. And now because the unique ID one unique ID is only contained to the one user, we can just say select the first item, and then because we need the email of that user, we will select email. So search for users whose unique ID is this unique ID, and get the first item, and first item's email address. So so we will get the email from here by this search. So the sender name could be Saint Javed, let's make it Bubble. Then we can say webhook test. Then in the body we can say hey. This is our test email. Test. So we can also get the name from here, and we will get the request data. We will get name from here that we had sent from here. Or what we can do is we can copy this expression, paste here, and get the name of that user as well. So now let's run this workflow. Let me open my Gmail. So this is the email that I should be getting the email to. So as you can currently see, I don't have any of the emails here. So now as you can see, I have removed the initialize from here, and what I will do is I will send a new call to this API and click on send. So it says success, and if I check my email, as you can see, I have gotten this email from Bubble, that we just set up. So this is how you can set all of your webhooks. You can make it you can make many use cases of it. Most of them could be payment methods like Stripe. You can whenever a user cancels subscription, You can have a webhook set up in Bubble that you will call from Stripe. So, and then you can cancel a user's subscription through webhook that Stripe will provide you. So if you wanted to wanted me to make a video on Stripe webhooks, please let me know and I will make those videos as well. Thank you so much for watching today. Have a good day. Bye bye.